Welcome, my friends, to Random Wednesday, this first week of Advent. You're praying with us here at the God Minute. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips.
And my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 51, A New Heart. Have mercy on me, O God, for I've messed up again. Sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, and in what I have left undone.
Can you make me a new heart, O God, and a right spirit? Can you break my willful plundering of all that is yours?
If I got it together again, others would follow. I could teach, guide, help, and I would.
O Lord, open my lips, that I may praise you. What you want is that new heart and right spirit. For this I pray.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
A reading from the Gospel according to John, chapter 3, verse 16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
She was five, sure of the facts, and recited them with slow solemnity, convinced every word was revelation. She said, they were so poor, they had only peanut butter and jelly sandwiches to eat. And they went a long way from home without getting lost. The lady rode a donkey, the man walked, and the baby was inside the lady. They had to stay in a stable with an ox and an ass. But the three rich men found them because a star lighted the roof. Shepherds came, and you could pet the sheep but not feed them. Then the baby was born. And do you know who he was? Her quarter eyes inflated to silver dollars. The baby was God. And she jumped in the air, whirled around, dove into the sofa, and buried her head under the cushion, which is the only proper response to the good news of the Incarnation. This rendition of the Christmas story was written by John Shea and is entitled Sharon's Christmas Prayer. It's found in his book, The Hour of the Unexpected. How very true that is. God becoming flesh out of love for us, you and me, is truly unexpected and genuinely unbelievable. In his book, Grace for the Moment, Max Licato says, if our greatest need had been information, God would have sent an educator. If our greatest need had been technology, God would have sent us a scientist. If our greatest need had been money, God would have sent us an economist. But since our greatest need was forgiveness, God sent us a Savior. I emphatically add, since our greatest need was love, God sent His Son. as a baby. No one is more helpless, vulnerable, dependent, lovable than a baby. The incarnation is all about how close God wants to be to us. On his journey to live with us, his first stop was a womb. Look deep within Mary. Better still, look deep within yourself. Jesus grew in Mary until he had to come out, and he will grow in each of us until the same occurs. He will come out in our speech, in our actions, in our decisions. Every place we live can be a Bethlehem. Every day we live can be Christmas. In gratitude to our awesome God for the gift of his Son, in wonder and awe, let each of us deliver Jesus to our troubled world.
Let us pray together the words that our Savior taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Look with favor, Lord God, upon your people. Grant us your compassionate help that, consoled by the presence of your Son, whose coming we now await, we may be tainted no longer by the corruption of former ways, but live only in you, by you, and for you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you all for joining us in prayer today. May the Lord continue to bless your day.